Welcome back to my channel, guys. I'm Sammy and this is Sammy Zilla. So yeah, so much happy to have you guys back again, and I really hope that you guys are having a great safe days back at home. Well, I know the pandemic is still on, but I am trying to keep up with all my joy making this amazing video for you guys. If you're here for the first time, do not forget to subscribe my page and check out the rest of the videos that I have all about, you know, skincare, haircare and makeup. And today we are going to do a full face makeup tutorial creating this look. So yeah, I thought I'm going to do a very subtle festive look, and I wanted to play with a little bit of colors on the eye. So this is what I've come up with, and let's not wait and get started with the look. I've already pulled my hair back. Let's start with the face and then we're going to move on to the eye makeup. So I'm going to use the primer first on my face. For that I have this one from Colourbar. So this is a perfect match primer. This gives quite a good matte effect and also blurs out all these little spores that I have on my face. We are going to do a matte makeup today, so my primer is also going to give me a mattifying effect. Make sure that all the products you use are matte if you want to go for a complete matte look. This one, Revolution Pro Pore Primer. I really love this one. I have been using it like 2 to 3 times, and this is a great product and it really blurs out my pores very nicely. This is the color. See, I can already feel the difference here. As you can see that these pores on my face are still prominent and this has blurred out a lot. So let's apply on the other part. Little bit on my nose. So let's move on to the foundation, and today I'm going to use this one for my matte look. This one is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. My shade is Natural Buff, and you know, during summer you want to go out and it's extremely hot outside, and if you have a skin like me which is oily and it sweats when you're out in the sun, then this foundation does an amazing job. Also go towards the neck area, especially if you're wearing a deep neckline like me. And you make sure that the foundation is also applied onto the entire skin portion that is showing off your body. And now it's time to blend, and for that I'm going to use this foundation brush. Quickly we'll blend it out. As you can see, this is super easy to use. It kind of gives like an airbrush finish. So we'll blend it all over, also on the neck area. Just for my self-satisfaction, I would like to dab it with a wet sponge. Done. So let's move on to the concealer. For that, I'm using this one, L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear Concealer. This also gives a great coverage under the eye, and it is a very light shade. I use the shade Amber. So a little bit here on the eye corner, and then towards the end we go upwards. So you know, when you apply your concealer on this manner, it just lifts your face, it goes upwards. So that's why it gives you a very chic and edgy feel. So I think this is the right way. I'm going to use this small sponge. So we are done with the under eye, and now I would use some concealer here on the lips corner and also here. And a little bit on my chin. Let's just blend it. So you can see how healthy my skin looks at this moment. We are done with the foundation and concealer, and you can see that how amazing, how nicely blended it is. And that is why I think I really love this foundation and this concealer, because it gives a great coverage and it blends very nicely, and it gives a very you know, healthy looking skin. So here it is, and now let's go on to the baking. And for that I'm going to use this powder from Maybelline Fit Me, and my shade is medium. I'll just tap it under my eye. So yeah, I'll keep it like this for the next 2 minutes, and let's move on to the contouring. This one is from Fenty Beauty and the shade is Truffle. A little bit here. And for blending, I'm going to use this one, a small sponge. It is already damp. So that's it. We are done with the contouring and now we can do just brush off the powder from the under eye. And now it's time for the compact powder. So I'm using this one from Fenty Beauty, Pro Filter Soft Matte Powder Foundation. My shade is 240. So I always use a sponge, so yeah, why not now? Tap it, tap it, tap it. Set the entire face. That's it, we are done. And now it's time for bronzer. So I'm using this one from Kiko Milano. This is a Flawless Fusion Bronzer Foundation and the shade is 03. Dusting off the excess and then slowly just work it out. So for my nose, I'll go for a smaller brush, and this is basically a buffing eyeshadow brush from the Morphe Jeffree Star collection, but it really helps me in contouring my nose, so I always use it. We're done with the face and now we're going to move on to the eyes. I'm going to apply the blush on and lipstick later on once my eye is done, and then maybe, you know, I can decide which colors I would like to go for my cheeks and lips. So let's start with the eyes. Excited, finally this is happening. And like I said earlier, that this is going to be a very soft, subtle, festive look. You know, you can like wear it at day, night, anytime you want to. You want to go for a party, for dinner. This is just one of the perfect eyes that anybody and everybody would love to go for. So let's start with prepping the eyes. I'm going to use this one. This is a eyeshadow primer potion from Urban Decay. This is a great product for your eyelids to make sure that your foundation is on place. There is no creases. Taking a little bit amount and applying it all over the eyelid, and I like to blend it with my finger just like this. In case if you have an eyeshadow base and not a primer, you can go for that as well. So I put on the eye primer and now we're going to put concealer. Now with the same wet sponge, dab it all around. And now to set the base, I am going to use the loose powder, the Fit Me loose powder, and apply all over the lid using the same sponge and just brush it out to remove the excess powder. So yeah, the eye base is done. And now let's start with the eye makeup. So I'm going to use this palette here. This is Desert Dusk eyeshadow palette from Huda. And we're going to use the shade Musk. This one. You can see that I've already used this palette quite a lot of times. I totally love the colors here, the shades, and all the colors are amazing and it really blends well. The pigmentation is great, so we're going to go for this one. So we're going to go for this blending eyeshadow brush and just apply it all over the crease. So for the base color, we're going to go for a very nude brown, nothing dark. Just because we are doing colorful eyeliner look. So let's keep the eyeshadow and the base very subtle so that, you know, the color liner just pops out. Though this eye primer from Urban Decay is a bit expensive, it cost around 2000, it is not easily affordable, but you know, if you are a lover of makeup, you sometimes need to invest in such products, and it goes a really long way, like you can use it for good 1 to 2 years. So let's move on and let's go on to the second layer of the eye, and I would like to have a little bit of glitter eyeshadow here, like from the inner corner towards the middle, just to give it a little bit more, you know, festive and a sparkly look. Nothing too much, but very, very subtle. And I'm going to use this shade from the palette, Retrograde. Using this flat brush, this is a very small flat brush, and there we go. That's it. Not too much from the inner corner towards the center. Let's go on to the next eye. And now it's time for the color liner. I'm going to use this one. This is from Lakme Absolute Kohl Pencil. This is a very nice, beautiful purple shade. And the shade name is Blackcurrant. Yeah, actually, that's actually a blackcurrant color. And just like an eyeliner, we're going to draw it from here to here. That's it. So the product is creamy, so you're going to have a little bit of extra products on your eyelid, but that is not a problem. We can easily blend it with an eyeliner brush. Yeah, so we got this beautiful black currant liner on, and now we're going to use an eyeliner brush and just blend it very nicely. So I'm going to use this triangular brush from Gub. I just have this spare one especially for doing all this. So we'll just going to take the liner. Now I've got some excess fallout here, so quickly brushing it off. And on the waterline, I'm going to use this emerald green color. This one is from Faces. So you're going to put it on the waterline. That's it. And it looks so pretty, right? And then just blend it. See how nicely the colors have popped out. So I'm going to take a little bit more brown, the same mask shade, and apply it here just to give it a more nice blended feel. And now we're going to put some highlighter here on the inner corner. So I'm going to take a silverish tone for my inner corner here. That's it. And this one, shade that I used, this is from Revolution highlighter palette. And now we're going to put mascara, and for that I'm going to use eyelash curler first using this mascara from Huda Beauty. So using the curl and length side first. There we go, the mascara is also done. And now let's move on to the eyebrows. So I'm going to use this brown shade from the dark brown Rimmel Brow This Way kit. So just quickly filling my brows. There we go, we are done with the eyebrows. And now we have the highlighter. For highlighter, I want to go with the same shade that I had put on this inner corner. You're done with the eye makeup, finally. And I think it's looking very lovely. And it's subtle yet glam, yet it's got a lot of colors. So yeah, I am loving the way it has come out. So let's quickly move on to the blush. I want to use this one. This is from MAC. This is a Rosy Does It Glow Play blush. This blush is a bit creamy, as you can see. It's a very lovely color. I think this will go with the dress that I'm wearing, because it has also got a lot of purple all over it. And with it, I would like to mix this one from Colourbar. This is Sweet Colour. We'll take a very little amount. And let's smile. And slowly apply it on the cheekbone. Guys, this blush is very pigmented, so make sure that you take a very little amount on the brush and blend it. And if you want it a little bit more darker, you can again reapply and build the shade. See what a lovely shade this is. It gives a very nice glow as well. And now we're going to go with the second shade using the same brush, a very little amount. So we are done with the blush, and I really love the way it is blended. The two colors are blended, and it is really complementing the eye makeup and the dress that I am wearing. So yeah, I am loving it already. And now let's go to the final thing, that is lipstick. So I'm going to first line my lips. I'm going to use this shade. Which is the shade? Hot Red 05 from the Swizz Beauty Bold Matte Lip Liner Set. So this lip set is again a great buy, guys. You have got 12 different shades that come in a box. It's from the brand Swizz Beauty again, and it's a very pocket friendly price, and the shades are really great and easy to work with. Starting off with my Cupid's bow, and then let's go to the lower line. So the lining is done, and now for the lipstick, I have got this beautiful 5 shades to choose from. This is again a great buy. This is a Fab 5 lipstick set from Rene, and I've used all the colors. All the colors are super easy to use, very soft, matte, and also it's moist. So yeah, let's see which color that we're gonna go for. Pink one, yeah. So let's take this flat brush and a little bit of compact powder. So you're done with the eye and the lips. The makeup is complete, and you know, if you want to go for a matte fixer, you can go for it, but as because I already have a matte base on, I have a matte primer on, so I'm not going for a fixer here. But in case if you want, you can go for it. But this last one thing that is left, that is applying highlighter on my cheekbones. So let's quickly do it, and again I'm going to use this palette. And I feel like using the same shade, maybe, you know, so that everything is exactly the same and it's complementing each other. I don't want to play with too many different highlighting shades here on the face. So that's my highlighter brush. We'll take the same shade just on the cheekbones. A little bit here on my nose and here on the chin. I'm just brushing it out. There we go, you're done. The blush, everything looks so nice. The highlighter is also looking very pretty. And I actually feel like going for a party right now after doing this makeup and all. But this final complete look is still left. So I'll quickly go up and put on my jewelry and the dupatta, and let's finally reveal the entire look. See you guys in a bit. So I'm back, and this is the final getup that I've done. I put on some bindi. I've got this beautiful gorgeous earrings on, nothing on my neck because this dupatta is already complementing my jewelry and my makeup. I hope that you guys are loving it. I'll just quickly give you a nice glimpse of the entire look here. I really had fun, you know, making this video with you guys, and I really hope that you guys enjoyed it. Do let me know in the comments, how did you guys like this look? I'll be waiting for all your queries and all your compliments, of course. Thank you so much for joining here with me at today's video. Very soon I'll meet you guys in the next one. If you're here for the first time, then do not forget to subscribe and also like and comment, and also go onto Insta and make sure that you follow me. My ID is Sammyzilla, SammyZilla. Thank you so much once again. Everybody be at home, take care, stay safe. Very soon I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.